Grazie a tutti. l'évangile, na baiti na vese upese na kuna korote na wana chambelo. Itulongo l'évangile, eti. Oba nene vazwana.
Amen. Was kasali sikuru munanga ikuwana munanga kativushna sivi sosiaga jehova kulamba na kamburi gele kakozele jehova shumushaga ikuwana fama fama shkarka yenda jehova shumushaga munanga ikuwana urisamarazi jehova munanga ikuwana urivana zdo jehova ukutimisa jehova uambeshani matimba jehova shumushaga unanga jehova akuna shimoni kashindaka njakawana jehova kama munanga irama wena usangu wakono sianga Aku kau nak kerja ini jawab sekurang kurangnya. Nada orang orang yang kita nak untuk berita, pemain nama orang orang itu ramai Jehovah. Orang orang itu kawan aku lah Jehovah. Ingat moni ya nama orang orang. Ibu nama orang Jehovah. Orang orang ingat tu ya nak kami itu orang Jehovah. Orang sendiri berita ini Jehovah. Orang orang guru mana orang usang ada tekan zaman usang. Aku mak bersama cium Jehovah sekurang kurangnya. Ibu orang orang ingat cium kasih kisah kau macam kawan orang Jehovah sekurang kurangnya. Ailungangi Jehovah. Kami cium itu orang tahu usang. Ilungi sosial. Tetelelo usatuan upati munanga O Jehovah, beka wana ipaso sanga Ibitele kuru la Yesu Kristo mpulishwa ina Amen
Jesus. thank God this afternoon. We are thankful for the services. Services proceeding from this place. Thank God for the power of God. Because it is His love.
Sunday school.
Thank God for the Sunday school. We get teachings. Thankful for the devotional service.
Holiness.
We learn about sanctification. That we must be sanctified. Without sanctification,
we
won't see heaven.
We are
thankful. This time.
It's
time for our evangelical service. It doesn't take time. We grasp what is coming out and we use it.
A timeless message. Revelation 14, verse 6.
Preaching in the wilderness. because it has
become
people following into the wilderness. He knew that the owner is coming with a message, a timeless
message.
In that very time, it's now old. But now, in our present time, that old timeless message, it still works even now. It's still fresh even now. To everyone who wants to must take it and live. We thank God for bringing the gospel. When he has heard that the message
is now
working, the message is now working.
Send
two of his disciples to go to Jesus, the one whom we have
about,
and ask him,
kuti uwe ore ukona lozi fanele simlinde na.
Is it you or is there another one that you must wait for?
Since the answer, Matthew 11, verse 4 and 5.
Our answer is in Matthew 11, verse 4 and 5.
Subone vangeli. Namandla wakho wevangeli.
The power.
Siphila emhlabeni.
Living in this world.
Sinesiqiniseko.
With an assurance.
Usinayo uNkulunkulu ezimpilweni zethu.
That we have God in our lives.
Umenywa wonke umuntu.
Everyone is invited.
Bahluphekayo.
The poor.
Bagulayo.
The sick.
Banezinkinga.
The one that has
noma inkinga sinjani.
No matter how your problems are,
azi kunezinkinga emhlabeni.
You know there are problems in this world.
Ngiyakhumbula umphulo unokuthi umhlaba
uyahlaba. I remember the overseer would say the world is prickering.
We wabone imizi yonke igcwele lana.
You saw the houses here in the community.
Kuthiwa injengama novel.
It's like novels.
Imizi inento zawo ngaphakathi izixhuswa ngaphakathi.
Each and every household has got its own problems.
Nabancedakalayo ilabagijimela kwevangeli.
Those that will be helped, the ones
that nabancedakalayo ilabagijimela kuJesu.
Those that will be helped, the one who runs to Jesus.
Sekarang funde 4 and 5. Or do we look for another? He answered, "Hambai." The
answer was go and shoo him. Those things which
he did is his wife.
And see.
Kutiwa, the blind receive their sight.
Yes.
And the lame walk. The lepers are cleansed. And the deaf hear. The dead are raised up. And the poor have the gospel preached unto them. Hallelujah.
Amen. We are thankful. Yes, it has now arrived. Why are we troubled? What we have to do is just to take and live with our children, with our parents,
our grandfather.
It's so nice to live according to the gospel. At home there's peace. There are no sicknesses. There are no witches at home. There's security at home.
Oh,
we thank God
for
bringing us the gospel.
Mark 15 verse 1. The time has fulfilled.
Yes.
Yes.
And straightway in the morning, the chief priests had a consultation with the elders and scribes, and the whole council, and bound Jesus, and carried him away and delivered him to Pilate.
Mark. Mark 1, verse 15. Sorry.
Mark chapter 1.
Verse 15.
And saying, the time is fulfilled.
Yes.
And the kingdom of God is at hand.
Yeah.
Repent ye and believe the gospel.
Amen. Amen.
Mark 1, verse 15.
Yes. And saying, the time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel.
Amen.
Iskati says,
the time is fulfilled. The
message
has arrived to the people. Repent ye and believe the gospel. Give everything else and receive the gospel. There's nothing else.
What you was doing in the Sunday school?
We heard in the Sunday school.
Let us cut it. Beku palwa e machie ne nazi bukwini kuchwa balani e zandeni. Okay, umlaes.
Those days was told that you must write everywhere on the books, on the stones, on the heads, everywhere write the message. They always reminded each other that do not forget the message of God. Parents continually reminding the children. Now the timeless message has arrived. It is now written in the hearts.
The time is fulfilled.
All the laws of God, all the commandments of God are written in the hearts. There's no one who tell another and say, I know God. There's no one who tell the other that you must
be because
it will now be written in the heart. You repented from sin.
And
prayed and sins were forgiven. It is written in the heart to receive the gospel, to receive the owner.
Ezekiel 36.
The one whom we heard about in Ezekiel 36, verse 25. I will take away a stony heart and put in a heart of flesh. And will pour my spirit into
you
so that it may walk according to my statutes. Thankful for the gospel.
The time is fulfilled.
It's up to you. It's up to you, mother, father, brother, sister,
the
Take and live. The gospel has been set. There's nothing else left.
The problem they call.
It's a problem that we
are. We from 7 to 2.
Big work has been
done.
To bring this message. Jesus died.
He
was crucified. Died a painful death. The vein was cut in
twain.
So that each and everyone may go
in
and take for himself and leave.
It
will be so painful to receive nothing. You are taken during the time of Moses and you
were set out.
It is said that the times of the prophets, they wanted to see this
present
time. They wished to see this present
time.
For a person to live, having the message within their heart, reminding him time and again, making him to walk
time.
During those times, it was just written in the book. Now it's written in the heart. When you walk, there's something talking to you. There's something teaching you. There's something telling you.
Then
where are you walking? You know, come out from there and walk this
way.
Come out from that place and enter
into
it. If you are lacking this thing, remind you. It's now time, go into prayer. This thing will tell you that ahead there is time. There's time where you have to account for. Now you must make right your ways now. The painful thing is for you to get
there
without receiving
this.
You will be asked, why were you walking such a great work was made. Didn't you hear the message? For you to walk
according.
You are walking, stepping on the wrong place. Why did you receive the message? Why didn't you receive the gospel? To leave. Until you reach this
place.
Where we are. Now look. All your words have caused you
to
have failed to because of your words which you have done. Let us remember. That rich man
was
staying in high places. On the other hand, Lazarus was
born.
But he was heard the message. When his time arrived, say that the angels took Lazarus, took him to Abraham's boss. It shows that when a person
is born,
without this, he's been taken
out.
He's taken to the place
where
the rich man, he died. And he was buried.
But in a lower world.
But on the other side, he saw Lazarus. He was told. When he asked for
food.
Remember the time the food which you were eating, the
world.
He forgot to take the
message.
Here's Lazarus. He was
blind.
In his
life,
he had the message.
No more to beg a man.
Even if you have
one of life,
you must hold
on to the message. No more to beg.
Even if you can
reach,
you must carry the message. The rich man forgot to take the message. He wanted a place to be prepared for
him.
But his words denying him was in a bad place. He wanted help from Lazarus. But he didn't help Lazarus when he was living in the world. He was asking for water. To dip his finger and to put into his mouth. On the other hand, he wasn't drinking water, he was drinking wine. Now the question is, to us now, when this time arrives, do we have this message? Or we come to church and walk
out?
Didn't we hear the message? Now Jesus is saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent ye and receive the gospel. What is it that you have now that you will account for? Whatever that when you get there will be
before.
Because it is the one that's supposed to account for
you.
It's the one that's supposed to take you forward. Say when they die, their sins will be
removed,
and some after them. He'll be in between his sins. They'll be walking together, taking him to a place where sin has go. We must ask ourselves today. The message has arrived.
Matthew 11, verse 28.
And I have David, and I will give you rest. 29. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your soul.
Amen.
30. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
Amen.
Zodo.
Find rest of your souls. nizothola ukuphumula komoya wenu.
He shall find rest unto your souls.
Emphefumulo izophumula.
Your souls will rest.
Wazi noma waba strong.
Even if you be strong.
Usaphila manje.
While living now.
Noma unomzimba ongakanani ema muscle mangakanani.
You may have many muscles in your body.
But umoya wahlupheka.
But the soul is troubled.
Uba njenge hopeless, hopeless thing.
You're like a person with nothing.
But
Jesus
is
saying, come and take my yoke. You will find rest for your souls.
Man is a pillar. Na mazeni hambile nkosini.
When you are still alive, even when you have gone up to the Lord.
For my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
Amen.
Siyazinikeza amanye amajoko.
You know, we give ourselves different yokes.
Amanye amajoko, ijoko.
Yoke, yes.
Angafanelanga.
Yokes that are not fit for us.
Umuntu asuke.
A person will come.
Aye, ayothwala ijoko wherever ayakhona. Ayothwala ijoko.
And go and carry a yoke from wherever that you would have been.
Imsene.
It will be so heavy to you.
Asule nokuhamba.
You will even fail to walk.
And then apa uJesu athi wozani kimi ngithule.
And Jesus is saying, come unto me, let me give you rest.
Abanye bayothwala ijoko labanye libasindayo.
Some will go and carry another person's yoke, which is heavy for them.
I've
got my yoke. It's heavy for me. I cannot even walk with you. You come to me. And you say, I want what you have. And then I offload my
yoke.
And I put it on top of you. And now you are failing to walk. You will not come back to me. Because I'm not looking at the other side. I don't want to hear anything. But Jesus is saying, come unto me. And take my yoke. See how easy is the yoke of Jesus. You wake up in the morning. You pray. I thank thee. You're with me at night. I slept like the dead.
But now one voice.
And you waking me up. In the afternoon. I thank you, God. You
were
with me from morning to night. I thank you,
God.
In the evening. I thank thee, God. You
kept
me throughout the whole day. I didn't go into
prayer.
I'm about to sleep. You wake up.
You
give that
yoke.
That's the yoke of Jesus. And home there's peace. There are no sicknesses at home. There are no funny stuff at home. Things, big things
running
off like a cow. There's nothing like that.
He
says, come unto me.
He's on the tulam twa.
And I'll give you rest. Some are refusing. They come to church.
Let me try.
With their burdens. They walk in. They walk out still. It's like a person walking through the street carrying
luggage.
He says, come, let me give you a
little
bit.
He
says, put down your burdens. Put
down.
And sit down. And I'll go with you. The person is still
giving them out.
He's getting himself with their burden on top.
Oh,
it's very deep.
Is
that the gospel?
It says it was to them.
It came to take
our
place. Is that the message?
Where are they?
The message of the gospel.
And in a man.
And it has power.
Unkulunkulu enter something good.
God is doing something in
you.
When you've received
it.
When you receive the
gospel. Enter something good.
God does something in you.
You don't remain the same.
Our Father.
No. You don't remain the same.
Our Father.
If you were a drunkard yesterday, today you are a new person.
It was a happy day.
It was a happy day.
When I was born again.
It was a happy day.
to drink. I drink it no more. The beer I used to drink. I drink it no more. The beer I used to drink. I drink it no more. It was a happy day when I was born again.
I want to assure you. Get the gospel and be born again. You will never go back where you've been yesterday. If you were drinking, you will not drink again. If you were smoking, you will not smoke again. If you were beating your wife, you will not beat her again. If you were playing with the mind of your children, you will not do that again. You will love everyone. Gospel. Power.
Amanda.
To everyone who receive it. Last verse. John 1 verse 12.
Amen. John 1 verse 12.
John 1 verse 12.
John 1 verse 12.
Yes.
But as many as received
him, as many as received the word of God,
so them gave he power to become.
Jesus gave them power to be the children of God.
Amen.
Even to them that believe on his name.
Amen. Zulu. Venda. Amen. Venda and Shona. Yes. Shona. Shona.
Amen.
Mind is cut.
Now's the time. For everyone to take this message.
My cut.
Now's the time. To live and to live and to
cut.
Now's the time. To come out from the troubles. And take what God is giving. And take what God has set before you. And live for God.
Evangelion.